Hello, this is Dr. Rohde. In this tutorial, we will show how to use the TI84 calculator to compute percentiles in the normal distribution. Let's look at this example here. The WAIS IQ test is normally distributed with a mean of 100 and a standard deviation of 15. Find the following values to complete the statements. A. The 80th percentile of IQ scores is equal to B. The minimum IQ score an individual must have to be in the top 2% of all individuals is. Well, there is a function on the calculator that will find percentiles in the normal distribution. Now, if you think about what we're doing here is we already know the percentage. In this case, we want the 80th percentile. So we know that whatever value we get, the probability of being at or below that value is 80%. That's the definition of a percentile. So we know the probability, and what we're trying to do is find the value that goes with it. Now, we used normal CDF in the past in order to find probabilities in a normal distribution. So now we're going to do the reverse of that. And if you think about algebra, when you learned about having a function and then you have another function that reverses it, we call that an inverse function. And what we're going to run in the calculator will be the inverse norm function, which does the backwards of what normal CDF does. Normal CDF, given some numbers, you can find the probability within those ranges. In this case, I'm given the probability in a sense already, and I want to find the value that would correspond to it. So I'm going to go to my distribution menu in the calculator, which is above the VARS button. So I'm going to hit second, and I'm going to hit VARS to activate the distribution menu. And if you look at choice number 3, inverse normal, or inverse norm, you can arrow down to the choice or hit the number 3. And in the TI84, I get this menu here, which guides me to what I want to do. So here we already know the probability or the area under the curve. And this function, inverse norm, only gives percentiles. So what I need to do is enter as my area the percentile as a decimal. So 80th percentile would be 0.8. And then I want to enter my mean and my standard deviation. Well, the mean was given in the problem as 100. So I go down there, and I'm going to enter 100. And then I'm going to arrow down, and I'm going to enter the standard deviation, which is 15. Now I go down to paste, and when I hit enter on paste, the calculator will paste the command for the inverse normal on the command screen. So here's how the command looks on the command screen. Inverse norm 0.8, 100, 15. So I hit enter again, and I get my value, the 80th percentile, 112.62. So when you get IQ scores, they don't generally give you decimal scores, so I'll go ahead and round this to 113. If I put 112, that's actually slightly less than the 80th percentile. If I put 113, that might be like the 80.5 or something like that. But, you know, we're getting close, you know, and we'll just round it to 113. Again, round to the number of decimals in which the question you're answering tells you to. Now for the second part, the minimum IQ score an individual must have to be in the top 2% of all individuals is. Well, I'm going to use the inverse normal again because I have the percentage. In this case, whatever score I'm at, 2% is above it in the normal bell curve. So I'm going to use the inverse norm function again, second VARS, and then I'm going to choose number 3 for the inverse normal function. Now, in this case, though, for the area, I have to think, inverse normal only finds percentiles. So I have to convert the top 2% to the equivalent percentile, which if 2% is above a value, then 98% must be below it, because the total of everything is 100%. So my area here will be 0.98, because the equivalent to the top 2% is the 98th percentile. And since the inverse norm finds percentiles, I need to put in the percentile here as a decimal. The mean and standard deviation are still 115. So I'll arrow down to paste so that it will paste into the command screen the inverse normal command for the 98th percentile, 0.98, and the distribution with a mean of 100 and standard deviation of 15. So I get 130.8. Well, they must score at least 130.8. So the minimum score, since it give you a whole number of values, is going to be 131. So the minimum score an individual must have on the IQ test to be in the top 2% is 131.